This is a very basic C++ program composed primarily of cout statements, which is our output to the standard output device, our monitor or screen. So if we read this first line, we're redirecting to the output device a series of asterisk characters with the final goal of outputting a couple of letters composed of the asterisk character out to the screen, in this case P and T. So line by line here, though, we're printing, you know, six asterisks, a few spaces, and then seven asterisks to compose that top line of those two characters. So that's going to go out to the screen. Then the inline character, remember, will make sure that our output goes to the next line before we print the next line, next cout statement. And then remember, all C++ statements end with a semicolon, so that ends our statement. So we have these series of statements, and we just keep doing that. And notice we try to line things up so we can kind of see what the output's going to look like just by looking at our program. So let's compile that and run it. And we'll see on our screen that's what we pretty much get. A P and a T character composed of the character with asterisks. So fairly simple program. Try to keep things neat like this. We can always do weird things like this, where we have, you know, everything's written on one line, one cout statement. And I'll show you, it actually does the same thing, compile and run. And we get the same P and T. So it does the same thing. But, I mean, this is much more maintainable. Kind of imagine the scenario where I give you this program and say, hey, we want to add another letter to the end of this series of characters, which is going to be more maintainable. If I ask you to modify this to do that, or this, I mean, you can just add in some spaces here and continue the next character, whatever it might be. So keep that in mind as you write programs. It's a big concept in programming is maintainability. In other words, if I pick this program up a week, a month, or even a year from now, will I be able to understand what's going on and edit it to make it do something slightly different? Okay, so there's a lot of code reuse in programming. Let's look at one other thing here. If we did a slightly more complicated program, we've got these, you know, more three-dimensional letters here. Now, keep in mind, there's a gotcha in C++. What I've done here is I have some of these characters, like this one, is the backslash character. And remember, in C++, inside quotes, the backslash is an escape character. So it usually says something special, like the backslash N is coming, the new line character, or backslash A alert, usually used for error messages to kind of get the user's attention. So keep in mind, if I line this up so you can kind of see what the letters are going to look like, but all these backslashes, I need to change to two backslashes. So one will be the escape, and the second one is saying, hey, the special character is the backslash. So what I'll do is convert all those backslashes into double backslashes. Makes it a little bit harder to read this, but it's necessary if you put a backslash on the screen to escape it with another backslash. So you got to have two to make one. So let's compile that and run it to see that that was actually necessary. So notice on the screen, just one backslash prints for that. Okay, so that's kind of a short lesson on the cout statement, or the C++ output statement.